Speaking of hearts, heart disease is the leading cause of death here in the United States. And our friends at Intermountain Healthcare, they want to remind us all of the importance of staying active, continuing to have regular checkups, and addressing medical concerns, especially during the pandemic. Have a look.
Activity and eating well really makes such a difference, because actually, if you want to look at numbers, and we talk about numbers a lot, 70% of chronic disease is because of lifestyle issues. So if we can stay active, not be sedentary, if we can try to eat real food, not processed food, not always, again, fast food, but those things make such a difference in our lifelong cardiovascular heart health. Of course, bad habits, smoking, for example, you know, when you come to a cardiologist, if I don't tell you, you shouldn't smoke, I'm not doing my job, okay? So in large part, when you look at lifestyle things, no smoking, blood pressure control, regular checkups, making sure that you're kind of minding the store a little bit, those are all key pieces. And our symptoms basically of what is heart discomfort, and we choose that word instead of pain, because a lot of times it's a heaviness, a tightness, a pressure sensation. It's not always just this crushing chest pain like you see sometimes on TV. It can be up in the neck or the jaw. It can be in the arms. And then there's also the associated feeling of you can't quite get your breath. You know, it just can't catch that breath. Those are symptoms that tend to point towards something that maybe that heart is not getting enough blood flow, is not working at its usual capacity, and is being affected by something. Our My Generation population frequently comes to see us, and it's not just because they have a symptom or they have a heart problem, but sometimes that's also because maybe they have things that could lead to that. And so ultimately, again, our My Generation and cardiology is truly a collaboration and a cooperative model of care, and we're real focused on the fact to keep them well and to keep them away from the hospital. Across the country, as we've now sort of tried to find our way through COVID, people that have had symptoms that are heart symptoms also haven't come to the emergency room. They've come late. They've come after they've had their heart attack. They're in trouble by the time they get there. So the real message is, please don't wait. Don't sit at home with that chest discomfort feeling really horrible. Call 911. Do things so that you get help, and you get help now.